Hi, I'm Dr. Randy Morris. I'm a board-certified fertility expert and the medical director at IVF1 here in the Naperville Fertility Center. And this is Infertility TV. Women with PCOS have more difficulty getting pregnant. The main reason is that they don't ovulate. Getting women with PCOS to ovulate can be tricky. Luckily, there are a number of options. A common reason why women with PCOS don't ovulate is insulin resistance. Methods to reduce insulin resistance can often get ovulation to occur. Three ways to reduce insulin resistance are weight loss, exercise, and medications. The most commonly used medication in PCOS patients to reduce insulin resistance is called metformin. Fertility medications are also used to induce ovulation. Most people are familiar with a fertility pill called Clomid. However, many women with PCOS don't respond to Clomid. A better choice is another pill called letrozole. Injections of fertility medications can also be used to get ovulation to occur, but be careful. There is a much greater risk for multiple pregnancies with injections. Finally, surgery on the ovary can be used to induce ovulation. This surgery is performed through laparoscopy and uses a laser or electric current to vaporize the cells in the ovary that are responsible for some of the hormone abnormalities in PCOS. Each option has pros and cons. Here at IVF1, we will review the advantages and disadvantages of each option to help you decide which is best for you. If you like this video, remember to like this video. Have a question? Leave it in the comments below. Infertility TV is broadcast weekly. Don't miss any episodes. Click here to subscribe. Click here to visit our website where you can register to become a patient.